Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. were alive today, I believe he would say this about Muhammad Ali's contribution to society. The ultimate measure of a man is not where he stands in moments of comfort and convenience, but where he stands in times of challenge and controversy. So when I think of Muhammad Ali, he stands very tall to me. The mighty Muhammad Ali has left us for a mantle in heaven, but his legacy will live on forever. He was more than a fighter in the ring, known to go 12 rounds with heavy weights. He also fell outside of the ring for the rights of people like you and me. Ali had a following in the civil rights movement that even I would envy. His mere presence in the room immediately commanded your attention, and you could never miss something because he would always let you know. The champ is here. His confidence was inspiring, and the words he spoke were so meaningful and poetic that each and every one of us have to stop and listen. Much greater than his fists, he used his voice and his status as a platform for social change. He first shook up the world when he began listening, but even more so when he changed his birth name, slave name, Cassius Clay, and became Muhammad Ali. That alone made people of color proud to be who they are and stand up for what they believe. He continued to fight against oppression when he refused to serve in the U.S. Army and fight in the Vietnam War, which is war that I myself did not endorse. He told our white counterparts to challenge his decisions. You, my opposer, what I want freedom. You, my opposer, what I want justice. You, my opposer, what I want equality. You want me to go somewhere and fight, but you don't even stand up for me here at home. He ended up being sentenced to prison and shoved out of his boxing title, which was overturned 4 years later in the Supreme Court appeal. Through it all, Ali ultimately knew he gained much more than he had lost, and his courage encouraged us all to keep fighting for what is right. As I had said before, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. Ali's actions back then have allowed others to take the same stand for justice today in 2017. In our early years, black men were being lynched and hung from trees. But today, our black men are being shot and killed without regard. That is why athletes such as Colin Kaepernick of the San Francisco 49ers have refused to pledge allegiance to a flag that promises liberty and justice for all. When society is showing differently, much like Ali, Kaepernick continues to stand against oppression without fear of losing football, his fans, or his endorsements. And what greater accomplishment is there than to serve as an inspiration to others? In his greatest fight of them all with Parkinson's disease, Muhammad Ali continues to stand up for what he believed. He traveled the world seeking the release of American hostages and even challenged recent 2016 presidential candidates on their comments regarding Muslims in America. Until death, he promoted liberty and justice for all. His life is an example of what I meant when I said, our lives begin to end the day we become formed by things that matter. If Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. were alive today, I believe he would say, life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? And my friend Muhammad Ali did more in his lifetime for others than I can share with you today. I was proud to work along with him and fight for the civil rights movement and was inspired by his confidence and courage. He summed it all up himself when he said, service to others is the rent you pay for your room here on earth. And I have to say that Muhammad Ali has served us all very well.